Greetings, Commanders, this is Pagan, Horde, and we're looking at 163 of the Roguetech playthrough. Now, what is going on? Well, last episode we got ourselves a Gaussinator fight and found some very interesting items, which I am eager to put to the test. Thus, if you would please do some YouTube stuff, well, let's get it on. Now, what I'd like to do, I know there's the possibility of doing something like a Gauss-zilla with these improved Gauss, but at this point I don't think I'll have the time to do like a 4D mission affinity for a new pilot and all that. So perhaps we can just recycle our second Oberjäger here, who's not as performing as much as the Brut. Still very good, but the ballistic suit will work with ballistic weapon. Get like Gauss, so there you go. Let's just use him. He's already equipped. We're just gonna change his ballistic profile and see what we can do. As he is now, he has 48 tons remaining. That's fine. And let's put those Gauss improved to the test. Now, these Gauss improved, they have their optimal range of 660. That is bananas. Only one recoil, and the ballistic suit will negate that recoil. So, 15% chance of knockdown, a 115 ton with piloting and all that should be able to handle a 30% chance of knockdown. Yeah, without additional shenanigans. What kind of ammo do you use? I'm not sure. Use a heavy Gauss or normal Gauss ammo? Let's find out. Normal Gauss ammo. That's even better. I have 20 shots for this. Let's give you... will 14 be enough? Let's give you 2. You're gonna have 20 Alpha Strike. There you go. You're good. And the heat efficiency will be through the roof. Indeed. That is sweet. Wow. 5 heat per... Alright, well, I still have 14 tons to play with. You are a very competent mech, as you are already, and your pilot already has affinity for more ballistic accuracy, so, you know, you're just gonna be just fine as is. Let's put some backup weapon and maybe an AMS, and you'll be good to go. Now, the thing is, I don't have much that has an optimal range of 660 that can, you know, work with this. Perhaps Ultra 2s? Ultra 2s have an optimal of 540. I mean, if I just put 2 Ultra 2s, it's 100 more damage. So you're not going to do that much damage, actually. This is just 110 each, and then, yeah. Technically, you have a profile of only 320 damage. But this would be at extreme range. Or do I just... that's a possibility, isn't it? Do I add another 200 instead? But it's a much shorter range. That would be too much knockdown. What about a regular Gauss as backup? 80 damage, 450 range. I'm thinking. Because this could be a headshotter. I mean, does the ballistic suit allow to do headshots? I'm assuming it does. If it does, we could try doing some headshots with this. So do we put another Gauss or backup weapons, really? The only complaint that I have about the Uberjäger is that the support hardpoint is in the head, and the head is completely filled. Thus, the support hardpoint is useless. I mean, that would be funny. But you would be skipping out on all the beautiful ballistic bonuses, so we won't. Okay, I'll stick with what I was thinking earlier of Twin Ultra 2. Just to add more damage. We'll try the headshot first, if it is even possible with this guy or not, we'll find out. And then we can make maybe try a third Gauss and go for headshot. That is a possibility. So Ultra 2, a caseless will be 60 shot. I think that'll be enough. Wow. And there you go. So I don't have possibility of AMS like we discussed. The heat is ridiculously fine. So what do I do with the rest of you? With 3 tons. We already have a UAV compartment on you, because you don't need an exchanger. It's not like I can add this, no. Thinking. You're already good on this. If I remove the pyrofibrous, it's 1.5 ton. Since you're pretty cold, should we go the stealth route instead? Do we have super heavy stealth armor clan? It weighs 6 tons instead of a. Super heavy stealth armor. Do you weigh something? You weigh 4. Provides sensor stealth when activated, making this unit hard to hit and detect. Use component menu to toggle. 30% counter to probe. Minus 10% visibility, minus 10% sensor. One slot except health and... that's awesome. You don't need the head with this one. Requires an ECM. Okay. Signature dampener. Can't be used with this mech. Okay. Well, this works. But now we're too heavy. Because this is actually heavy. This is one of the rare occasions when we have plenty of room. So let's put as much patchwork as we can. You already have a T2 here, a T1 here. Let's replace a T1 with a T3. That is six tons, so we're not going to be able to do that. But I'm curious to try this like this, as just being a sniper. It's only 220 damage like this, however, compared to most of our monsters who do more than twice as that. But the possibility of being a sniper is intriguing. Alright, well, if we go down that road, let's try it for shit and giggles. What do we do as backup? Sorry, I mean, I could give you medium lasers and all that, but this would be fairly useless. I have not kept any machine guns or stuff like that because of their short range have been fairly useless to me for a long time. I kind of regret it now. Like, a bunch of machine gun array would have been funny. I'm looking for suggestion on that one because I'm running out of ideas. It's one of the rare curses when there's too much room and I'm not sure what to do. I mean, I can give you an XXL and now you have 7 tons. With 7 tons, I can add 1 weapon. So let's do that. I'm going to clear. So if you guys have any idea on what I'm missing in the comment, I'm running out. And this is one of the weird ones when I'm a lot of room, but not really sure. So hoping for suggestion. I'm quite bummed that I cannot simply put on an AMS and call it a day. Because that would have been fix everything. I mean, I can just put some medium lasers, or too small, and that. It's not like I'm ever gonna use them, but just to finish the weight. So let's try this. Let's see if we can actually try headshots with you, because that would potentially make you a monster. And we shall see. Very well. Anything else we want to do? If we go to our regular McBay, to the circuit. Can we put you back on an only clan now that we've gotten a wee bit of ammo out of the other one? Not yet. Okay. This is working fine, and honestly, I'm kind of curious to build an NLRM in similar fashion. The FAF, what do you have in terms of problem? Just need to press the repair button and to replace your optic. Okay. I can do that. Alright, so what do we do next? Now, we've run out of super heavy mission in this planet. I think it'll be fun to try again just a regular mission to compare the schnitz and the giggles. So we're gonna put the 2 Uber Jäger to the front. Let's get those repaired. Then we're gonna do a regular ass mission and test out the improved Gauss for the fun of it. Next episode I'm gonna go find a super hard mission to test out. But for now, let's just have fun. Best Rifleman. Well, that's a good name for that one, because we're going to have a quote-unquote Rifleman with improved Gauss. This is still a difficulty 21. We could have some surprises. These guys, their mech are not ready. We have enough room for the A1. The A1 is that the one we want. There we go. It is a 820, however. Shieldron Prime. But do I bring the Paladin? Do I need a Paladin in a regular mission? Probably not. Let's be honest. It's still very funny to use. So I'll keep it for the shit and the giggles. So we'll just remove our little catapult. And we're going to be exactly 120. This means we won't have much frontliner, we have only three frontliner really. But that's fine. Let's test out this guy using, pardon me, this guy using a stealth and see if the headshot works. This should be fun. See you guys in a moment. Marvelous, I got my coffee and we're going on a bug hunt. Let's go. Now, it's been a while since we have done a regular ass mission with only one support lance. So this will be a nice point of comparison, because after that I'm going to try and find out a new harder mission, where we'll probably get a wrecked sandwich again. But, you know, point of comparison, different kind of difficulty is the point of this. So we have one support enemy force and probably only one support lance in theory. So we would have only 9 enemies. We haven't seen 9 enemies anywhere in a really long time. Okay. So, the terrorist is in the middle of the ocean. Well, body of water. But that's gonna slow him down a lot. These guys are here. I mean, for once, I don't feel the need to go all the way in the back and do a hide behind a mountain and all that. I could probably just wreck them right away. So let's go old school. Old school, I would go as, I mean, if I were like back in the day doing online stuff, I would go as close as I can to the target so that I could wreck things as fast as possible. So let's see if that works now. Wow, only 9 enemies. Cyclops. Highlander. Atlas. Highlander. Those are rich pirates. Oh, we're getting Highlander 2Cs.
Talk to me.
Very well, Orion. It's good you're here.
Aye, aye.
Conquistador! I haven't seen you in a while. Conquistador is an incredibly good in the heavy category.
Moving out.
Self-repair, Omni, and all that jazz. He's extremely good.
How's it going?
His only downside is that the quirk of that mechs are not incredibly good compared to something like the sniper quirk of the Orion. The sniper quirk is by far my favorite.
Standing by.
Other than the missiles, like something like the Jormungandr. Our new Gauss rifle improved. Will I get a chance to shine? Since these guys are probably not gonna have much
Commander?
Evasion being down in the water.
I'm there.
Not only that, but you can see how the game is more responsive and goes faster because there's a lot less enemies on the field.
Yes.
Even with the rain animation, things are going smoothly.
Position confirmed.
For Roguetech. And the Unity engine. Alright, let's get it on. Twenty-three is the Conquistador himself. He is now out of sight, okay. Little blap from the Atlas.
Light damage, Commander.
Uh-huh.
How can I help?
Very well, Orion. Just be yourself. Can I get a flanking shot? No. That'll do.
Accelerating.
You will be accurate as usual, I'm fairly sure. Especially if I turn this on.
Roger that.
That is a very nice shave.
Waiting on you, Commander.
And next is the Stalker. What do I see all the way over there? The Islander, okay.
No sweat.
Let's keep hammering the Cyclops. Let's not give him a chance. Looking pretty thin. Ow, that was accurate.
Took a hard hit there. Ready for orders.
Demolisher, let's hit those two in the back there.
Affirmative.
The rest of the direct fire mech will be enough to take care of the Cyclops in front of us, so let's just start softening up the rest of the opposition.
Affirmative.
Boink, boink. No problem.
Uh-huh,
there we go! Improved Gauss rifle on the side shot. Only 75. Size delta, of course. Nice hits.
Yes, Commander.
Serket, well, just be yourself. Enjoy.
10-4.
Oof.
Scarred a critical
hit. This 150 missile of die now, please. I won't even need to crank you more than this. There we go.
Show 'em what you can. That's a kill.
I like this. Like old school brawls.
Waiting for order.
Happy. Boink boink.
Confirm.
This Highlander is regretting his life choices right now. We have a battle armor somewhere. I wonder how many hours I've waited against battle armor if you sum up this entire playthrough.
Mech warriors, shoot!
I've got your back.
Actually, never mind, I don't want to know. Okay, you have a line on the Conquistador.
Right. Primary target.
No, it has the primary, sure.
Orders.
Might as well get him then.
On the move.
Hi there. How are you doing? Let me introduce you to Daka.
It's go time. Solid connection on that one.
The Brutjäger is definitely an Org Genova witness. Knock knock. Daka.
I've been sensor locked. I hear ya.
Let's get him. He's the main target, so might as well. Because he's gonna start running soon enough.
Damage is light. Yes, Commander. Affirmative.
Enjoy. Have some more.
Confirmed.
That's that.
I hope we can salvage that.
Of course, in the good old days, I would be working with the smallest map possible. I would go to normal size map. Now I have a 66% increase in size. That's mostly due to give us room to fight the big boys and the super heavies.
Ready for.
But of course, back in the day, I would go smallest map possible to go as quickly and efficiently destroy things.
Acknowledged.
Two hits. Wow, we got lucky on those hits, but it does demonstrate the power of that weapon. 100 pinpoint damage at such a good range. Ooh, a Dire Star. Beef has started doing a YouTube video again, which is great. And if you don't know, he's the creator of the Dire Star. Which in Roguetech is fairly useless right now because the AI doesn't fire all of his weapon like it used to.
Waiting for orders.
But nonetheless, if you've never seen the Dire Star video, You should do that next.
Target locked.
Now I know this was bad hit chance against him, but I was looking for crit seek, and there you go.
Enemy eliminated.
Happy. Happy, I believe this will be your new targets.
Acknowledged.
Oof.
Still retreat.
I think I heard the happy sound of dying battle armor.
Come on, people. Let's make it
good to go.
Warbor. These are nicely packed over there. Boing boing.
How can I help?
Orion. Now probably only the LRM and the AC5 will get there. I'll go LRM crit seek against him.
Say goodbye.
There
Morano.
We go.
Take that as a lesson. Ready for orders.
Now the Orc Genova with... Oh, hello! I was gonna say I'm gonna fire over there, but we find a beautiful Blood S. That's a very good mech. And also a very dangerous one. So I'm gonna do an offensive push now to lower your initiative. Because he's gonna be soon, and he could really hurt our Orc Genova Witness. So let's get him that heavy silver bullet Gauss clan.
I'm here.
Nothing less. Alright, let's go siege mode for extra accuracy. And let's get him.
Roger.
Gotcha.
Show him what you got.
Now things go a lot smoother when you're not afraid of getting railgunned. By default, you know?
Roger that. Firing on target.
And we don't have super elite pilot ready to destroy us at every corner. This is a dangerous annihilator though, and an archangel. These are dangerous mech, but now we are have a good setup to handle them. Boink, boink.
Let's go.
So yeah, so far I know it's only a small sample size, but the easier one support lance is easier.
Commander.
Circuit. Oh no, that's a paladin. Paladin. Well, I mean.
Taking the shot.
Boink.
Oh, yeah. It's on.
Ooh, here comes you. Yep.
You need more practice.
Receiving you.
Uber. Got nice 80 on you. 85 on the Archangel. Woohoo! Reach out and touch someone. I like it. We have a panic on the Dire Star. That's sweet. This means one less to deal with. Let's pivot with the Orion and fire on the Atlas. I can use my entire firepower on him.
Punch right through his armor.
Receiving you.
Shieldron. Let's go for the other side.
McWarrior. What's up, boss?
Same thing with you. Ah, this feels like old school rock there.
Let's go.
I'm receiving you.
When you're able to just get shit done.
Roger that.
Woo!
Let's make it happen. Critical hit, Commander.
Aye, aye.
All right. Well, might as well finish the job here. Gotcha.
Target eliminated.
Well then, I guess we're gonna be able to do a two mission in an episode again.
We can do this. Let's go.
Oh, airstrike, of course. Well, fuck.
Commander.
But, you know, at least having less elite pilot means less chance of airstrikes. So when there's one, it's okay. I mean, it's still an annoying mechanic, but when there's one, okay, fine, we'll deal with it. When there's six of them, then it's more annoying.
Give everything you got.
Orion, I'm gonna get out of the airstrike zone.
Roger. Full throttle.
And I can afford to just go forward.
Engaging target.
Now he has some damage reduction, so we didn't go through his armor, but this guy has plenty of armor to feed these.
What can I do for you?
He's gonna go boom eventually. So let's offensive push him. Mostly to make sure we get him before he fires again. Because right now I don't want to get a face full of those racks for one of our frontlander. One more time for shit and giggles. Yes?
Guys?
Oh, okay. Oh, ow. Severe attack. Demolisher.
Coordinates received.
Okay. There we go. Blah blah.
Target acquired. Oh, it's on now.
Not much left of him.
Scored a critical hit.
And he goes away. Perfect.
Yes, Commander.
Let's work on the last target.
Hot damn. Let's do it.
Standing by.
Oh, only the NLRM is reaching. I hesitate to go forward. We'll try. Hey, now everything reaches. Extreme range. But it is enough.
Orders.
And now we can use this wonderful new weapon.
On now.
To open the tin can.
Scored a critical hit.
Nice.
Receiving you.
Enjoy, buddy.
Knocking. Give them everything you've got.
You should panic. As if on cue. Well, listen. I know it's still a small sample size, but you can clearly see the difference.
Minimal damage.
And I would not recommend the Elite as its current iteration. I would not recommend the Elite Pilot mod to anyone. I know the mod says that it has access to unique mission and stuff like that, but not worth it. Because without it, well, you can see the strength of our actual lens, which is not something you could have done before when you were, you know, facing 20 of these guys.
Mission.
And I'll see you guys in a moment. Well, that felt good. Felt like old school rogue tech. If I had maybe a smaller map instead of 66% larger map, I believe I would have finished this mission in something like 12 minutes, which was 12 to 13 minutes was the goal of the online map. The online map, it had a buffer timer that if you posted a mission faster than 17 or 18 minutes, depending on the season, it was considered invalid. So you wanted to finish your mission in 12 to 13 minutes, because with loading time and traveling time and finding the mission, that was your bother zone. So I believe I would have succeeded in if I had a smaller map and be like an old school. That would have been and like an old school fight. So let's have a look. Do I have enough of this? I do. Do I have enough of this? I do. I'm actually interested in the Blood Asp, which is a really cool mech. What is your quirks? It's an Omni. Got one silver bullet Gauss that didn't blow up, I think. Yeah. It's an interesting weapon. 16 ton though. Damage 30 times 5 at 150.
Ooh.
At optimal range only 240. That's its. Ooh. 150 damage. That's not too shabby. Would later become the Hyper Gauss rifle, yeah. Speed follow 40% at long range, jam chance. Recoil mitigated by gunnery and rocker recoil reduction. Well, I mean, it's extremely strong. It's just optimal range just sucks. It's a society. It's a society weapon, yeah, it shows. I'm gonna take it for the shit and giggles. Let's see what we can do. The rest of the stuff here is... it's alright. We're gonna take a look at the blood asp. And I'll see you guys in a moment. Boss, I'm in awe. This will make us build on the permanent mount for those massive silver bullet Gauss. Classic example of picking a gun and then figuring out how to make it move. Interesting. And only 300,000 in 23 days, which for us is almost nothing. Like what? 15% of what a super heavy mission would be like? Come on. Alright, let's just move to 2 days and then take a look at that silver bullet Gauss. I'm not fond of the very short range nature of it though. Alright, so you have the sniper quirk, which is the best one in the game, in my opinion. You have the hardened plate, attack immune. Let's be honest, you rarely go over to 160, so the first two at 20 and 40 is what matters. And a silver bullet Gauss comes equipped with it. That's awesome, but you know, I'll be honest with you, this is too much a short range for the crew that we are running right now, so I don't see myself running this, but it is reasonably fast. Those weapons are awesome. Just 240 range is nothing compared to the hyper assault Gauss, which are 480, twice the range. Yeah. Well, we do get a Nova crew out of it. We do get a few other things. So this is really cool, but this is not really playable for us at this level of difficulty. We need much faster and longer range stuff. So we're not gonna keep it, but it was nice to take a look at this this platform. Very well. Now we're gonna continue our little experiment of doing easier mission to see how it looks like. For at least one more, because I believe we have time to cram two a mission in this episode, since they're going fairly quickly. And after that I will look for a proper super heavy mission. But for now, it is nice to, you know, just make some comparison to difficulty levels. And to do that, let's do a blackout, which we haven't done in a while. And the ones we've done have been largely unsuccessful. Mostly due to the fact that when we do them at our previous two support lands, we would automatically get two support lands of elite pilot and right away. So we were not able to compete. It usually boiled down to 4 against, 4 against 16, 20 if that's against clan, so it was unrealistic. But since we are now in a more realistic fashion, let's grab this. I would like to bring our Marauder 3. Because the energy boat will not be ammo dependent, just in case we go the it goes the distance. And we're gonna bring the Orion. So this will be an interesting group of four. And let's see how Blackout compares with one, only one, quote-unquote, easier support lance. See you guys in a moment. A minor royal pain, let's roll! Now, in the earlier game, in the at least the earlier in the season, stated that Black Elves were my favorite mission. They still are when they don't have, you know, two support lands of crazy stuff in your face when you start them. We'll see how it goes now. This is very bright. My eyes are already complaining.
On my way.
Affirmative. Confirmed.
So where are they? They can be a bit scattered everywhere. Okay. Got an atlas.
Systems holding.
I've got your back.
Oh, hello. We have a green line that goes all the way over there. Don't mind if I do.
Roger. Confirm.
Is that damnable annihilator with twin improved Gauss, heavy Gauss rifle? He's a dangerous boy. I just got hit by two ERPPCs. This is another dangerous guy out there.
Receiving you.
But, okay, let's take advantage of this guy first. We got a bounty hunter. That's the ERPPC, okay. Another 100 ton. Heavy metal. So those are dangerous mechs. Not Typhon. Let's go standard. Can I go Deadfire? Yeah. That's a lower hit chance, but 13 damage per missile.
Got it.
Woo! Well, there goes the heavy Gauss rifle. I'll take that.
Talk to me.
Punisher. Let's fire back against those PPCs. Let's do some PPC on PPC action. Let's just turn this on. And go blup.
Roger.
Nice. Did we get a headshot? We got a headshot.
That was sloppy, lad.
Ready for orders. Position confirmed.
I mean, do you still have... No, you don't have any weapons. You're no longer a threat. I'll fire on him instead. Oh, battle armor. Oh, it's 4 against 5, really. At 20. I also miss how the game is so much faster when you don't have that much enemies.
Copy that.
That's fine.
Locked on target.
The battle armor is soaking up a lot of damage, but it's still taking a beating. Which makes it pull out.
I copy.
Sure. Wow, Deadfire and ELRM is so nasty.
Target eliminated.
I love it.
I'm out of long range missiles.
Alright, so you pulled out, you are out of reach. What about the Atlas? The Atlas is hiding behind this hill. Very well. Let's just move. Heavy metal is the nicest name for a mech, but he's not great. He doesn't have great quirks. I really wish this mech was great and I would run five of them. Ooh, I am running extremely hot though. Let's not do Typhon because you are already open. Standard for crit seeking.
Hell yes.
Take something broke.
Reporting critical hit.
Not quite, but he's not looking good. tempted to reserve a bit, because maybe one of them will walk into our firing range instead of moving first. Not quite, it seemed, but it was worth a try.
How can I help? Sprinting.
Ah, here we are. So, heavy metal or Atlas? Heavy metal.
Let's see how you handle this.
Talk to me. Moving as fast as I can.
Ah, so much easier when it goes fast like this.
Mech warriors, show them what you got.
Du-du-du-du. Both of these are quite valid.
Firing full complement on enemy. It's go time. They've got a lock on me.
Sensor, okay. Sensor followed by a bit of missile. Sure.
Light damage, Commander.
They really, the AI really loves to target, to sensor lock the Jormungand. I don't know if you've paid a lot of attention on my, or if you've seen a few videos, but two-thirds of the time, if there's a sensor lock to be done, it's on the Jormungand here.
For House Arano.
Yuren is taking a few scratches.
Receiving you. Roger.
Enjoy, buddy. There we go.
Let's
armor
go.
Breached.
Tango down.
Talk to me.
Can you get an angle on the other dude? Not quite.
Moving at a sprint.
I have to be careful not to trigger the target zone now before I finish or at least cripple the Atlas.
Let's hit him hard.
Marauder is still out there.
Roger that.
I'm gonna give you vigilance. First volley on the Atlas.
Standing by.
Did that count as one? No. That does. We have one unit in the zone. Should I offensive push? Might as well. To make this initiative go down a bit.
No retreat. Reporting.
Got some ammo explosion.
Ready for orders.
Now, instead of firing on the Atlas, please try and crit seek this guy. Just like that.
That's a kill.
You'll have to do better than that.
Well, hit.
Lucky bastard.
So I wonder if it's the does the Elite Pilot mod slows the game down? Is it just the number of units? Because everything is reacting. I know it's only a few samples, but everything is reacting very faster now.
All weapons are go. I'll break them.
Less effing around.
Good to go. Let's move.
And I can just keep firing. There you go.
Let's do this. One last target.
Very well.
You've got my attention.
So, let's go in and see what's what. Ah, not quite enough. Okay.
Talk to me.
Ready for orders. Got it.
Let's just get you a bit of time to cool off. You just get some evasion. The rest of you go trigger this.
Affirmative.
It's not triggering?
Commander.
Did I miss something? Did the crab go too far back? Okay. Yep. Okay, another lance. Have a look. Heliopolis, really? With that's the twin sniper artillery Heliopolis. That's, yeah. Okay. What about this? Is Baba Yaga. That's no slouch. That's Xartos. That's the 100 ton quad. We've barely seen him in this playthrough at all. And a gargoyle. Not any gargoyle, a champion gargoyle. I'm suddenly no longer very confident. Okay.
Moving out. Aye, aye.
Let's hope we win some initiative. We do have the tower or the turrets on our side. This does mean that sometimes the AI will fire on the turrets because they're easier target. That should save our ass quite a bit.
Receiving you.
So, typically the trick is to fire on the one who just moved, because that means that one is no longer in spawn protection. So the gargoyle here will be a valid target.
All weapons, go!
Does have bulwark in.
Standing by.
If you get a side shot on that Iliopolis, what does it look like?
Received.
Not great, because it is spawn protection. But it's nonetheless what I got, so let's typhoon him.
Mech warriors, show them what you got.
Orders.
Can I get a shot on, yep, the gargoyle?
Aye, aye.
Only 50%.
Triggering an alpha. Follow my lead.
We still got him open.
Punch right through his armor.
17 is what? Alright. Firing again on the turret. That really is saving our asses right now.
You've got my attention. Follow my lead.
Enjoy.
Damn you for making me difference. I'll break him in two.
Almost Orion.
Take that as a lesson.
14, last but not least. Turrets again. That was a Baba, and there's the Xanthos left. What you got, Xanthos? Ow. Okay, you're the first one to actually fire on us. I'll take it.
Armor's in bad shape.
A few pews from the turrets. Ooh, 10 damage per missile, Calliope. That is no joke.
No retreat.
Talk to me.
Alright, actually... What's that? No, it's a charge. Never mind. So the Orion, you're gonna go over here. The Iliopolis has been typhoned and is now... Yeah, that should be a kill.
Stop.
Not quite, but good enough.
Punch right through his armor.
Ready for orders.
That will be done.
Moving to position.
Let's switch to standard.
All weapons are go. Alright. Done, folks.
Hurry up, all this down.
Tango down.
You've got my attention. Copy.
Now let's try and finish off the gargoyle. Let's go for a full blast. Got him.
Battle mech down.
We haven't used a Marauder in a while because when you get so much elite pilots, he has a size delta that is easy to hit. And he often gets targeted. But in a mission like this, I can bring it back on. Yeah.
Reporting. Major armor loss.
So, you just gave me your back though. Back with a kick, if I can. Oh, that's not what I wanted to do, but...
Let's go! No retreat!
Good enough for rock and roll.
Scored a critical hit.
Those are some good hits. Yeah.
Let's hit him hard.
Now, we can safely say that without those turrets, we would have taken a lot more damage.
Roger that.
And we'd be having a very different conversation right now.
More house.
You've been Orioned.
That's one less hostile on the...
I'm here.
Now, wow. The front is already open, so let's do the exact same thing. Boink.
No retreat.
There we go. Well, yeah, small simple size, but the game is so much more responsive and so much faster going without the elite pilot mod and so much more enemies.
Everything I've got.
Okay, I'm gonna make a little cut here and move ourselves to the second part, and I'll see you guys in a moment. Alright, we're ready to pop this off. Let's go in with the crab.
Position confirmed.
Nope, it did not trigger it. Never mind about this. There we go. Du-du-du-du. Cute fluff decks. But it's an ambush, so we're facing our fourth lance. Third in this, pardon me. It would have been fourth in another circumstance, but it's still 3-1. This is no slouch. Especially when we have Pirate Faff with double Rakten Pirate. That's those damnable Zeus who are in every goddamn mission. Cyclops. Another Cyclops, the same one. Okay. Well, all of that is no joke. And this is still my least favorite thing to happen in those missions, because you have no choice but to go inside the zone to pop the mission, and then order. These guys will have spawn protection.
Move order received.
And that damnable Zeus with its resistant to missile. But I do have Typhon to help make that happen.
You've got my attention.
Whoop. And you're also not resistant to PPC.
Fall in behind me.
So enjoy, buddy.
Here we go.
Typhon and PPCs, these are good combo.
What a waste. Talk to me.
Alright, now the rest of them have spawn protection. However, the Orion does seem not to care. Because the Orion is the Orion.
Roger that. For House Arano.
Now this is the part that I'm dreading. Spawn protection with double Rakten Pirate in your face. That's not nice.
Oh, you're in trouble now.
Oh, there we go. So that's one's a fail. So I'll admittedly doing Blackouts is much faster, more responsive, and only having one support lance means they're doable. But nonetheless, yeah, this is still the weak point, having to trigger this place with very dangerous enemies with spawn protection that you cannot stop them, you just have to wait until they fire. And then this happens. So I'm sorry this one is a fail. But nonetheless, the point of comparison was interesting. So I'll see you guys in a moment. Alright, so that'll conclude this one, I think. The improved Gauss rifles are a success. Things run faster and smoother with one support lance. And I still can't recommend doing blackouts at high level of difficulty for the bullshit you just witnessed. So thank you for watching. Thank you for watching until the end. Please do some YouTube stuff. Any button will do. And for next episode, I will try to find us a proper super heavy mission to test out this theory a bit further. Now let me know in the comment what you think about trying out this new this several different difficulty system and see how it pans out. See you next time. Greetings, Commanders, this is Pagan Horde, and we are looking at 163 of the Long War, no, pardon me, the Roguetech playthrough, blah 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 blah.